मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम नाराज मैथ्स फैकल्टी इन टारगेट स्कूल एट थर्ड बत्री। सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी डिस्कस अबाउट सिमिलर ट्रायंगल्स फर्स्ट थ्योरम, दैट इज बीपीटी थ्योरम। सो इन दैट वीडियो वी डिस्कस जस्ट टू एग्जांपल्स रिलेटेड टू दैट थ्योरम। यस, टुडे डिफरेंट टाइप्स, इफ इट इज एक्स वैल्यूज हाउ टू फाइंड बाय यूजिंग बीपीटी थ्योरम। Observe students, this problem: what value of x will make DE parallel to BC in the figure? We know that BPD theorem. Yes, what is BPD theorem? If a line is drawn parallel to one side of a triangle in two distinct points, then the points divided in the same ratio. That means here, observe here. What did they given? AD by DC equal to BE by EC. So according to the problem, approach the solution is by BPT. First of all, directly. So by BPT, AD by DC equal to, now so BE by EC. So AD value becomes 8x plus 9 by x plus 3 equal to 3x plus 4 by x. Yes, go for cross multiplication students. X of 8x plus 9 equal to x plus 3 into 3x plus 4. Yes, observe here. X into 8x, 8x square plus x into 9, 9x equal to. Here also has the same. X into 3x, 3x square plus x into 4, 4x plus 3 into 3x, 9x plus 3, 4 are 12. Yes, on both sides 9x and 9x get cancelled. Then plus 3x square transfer left side becomes minus 8x square minus 3x square, nothing but 5x square plus 4x transfer left side becomes minus, minus 4x minus 12 equal to 0. Okay students, understood all of you? Right. Next, what about next step? So here, this is in the form of quadratic equation. If it is quadratic equation, so followed by three methods also, better to use in the prime factorization method. By applying the prime factorization method, first of all, multiplied by constant value along with coefficient of x square. So that is minus 12 into 5 minus 60 minus 60. Right here, x term, that here minus 60 is split. Observe here, their value here minus 4x. How can express by splitting that coefficients? That means, observe, we are taking the factors of minus 60. Better to take minus 6 and minus 10. Sorry, minus 10 and 6. Here, middle line is represented sum of these values, minus 10 plus 6, nothing but minus 4, minus these two values is product, minus 10 into 6, nothing but minus 60. So this, observe here, this quadratic expression like this, that is 5x square and minus 4x. Minus 4x can be written as minus 10x plus 6x minus 12. Minus 12 equal to 0. This is the upper part, students. Listen carefully, all of you. Right. Next one. In first two terms, which is the common factor? Observe there. Which is the common factor? Yes. That is 5x as a common factor. So 5x of x minus 2 plus, in last two terms also, which is the common factor? It is also a 6. Then 6 of x minus 2 equal to 0. In both terms, which is the common factor? Yes, that is x minus 2 as a common factor. Then that implies x minus 2 of, and again remaining 5x here plus 6. 5x plus 6 equal to 0. 5x plus 6 equal to 0. So observe there only, the product of two factors is 0. Each factor must be 0. Any one factor is 0. Yes, observe students here, first equating two factors 0. Okay. observe students, after this x minus 2 equal to 0 or use the word or 5x plus 6 equal to 0. Okay, minus 2 transpose right side becomes plus, that is x equal to 2. Here plus 6 transpose right side becomes minus 6. So 5x equal to minus 6, then x equal to minus 6 by 5. So here 5x equal to minus 6, x equal to minus 6 by 5. So observe the diagram. X value means nothing but length. Length cannot be negative value. So that means we have taken only positive value. Therefore here x equal to 2 is the solution. X equal to 2 is the solution. So by using BPD theorem like this, approaching the solution students, I gave one homework problem and practice in your house carefully. Okay students? Yes, I gave one homework problem students, observe here only. In the figure, if BE is parallel to BC and AD equal to 3x minus 2 and also AD equal to 5x minus 4 and BD or BB equal to 7x minus 5, CE equal to 5x minus 3, then find x value. So by using BPD theorem, you can get the results students. Yes, practice your notes carefully. Yes, one more model of the students. This is page number 202, exercise 8.14 to cover students. What they give you observe, prove that a line drawn through the midpoint of one side of a triangle parallel to another side bisects the third side. So let me consider problem as a statement. Yes, we know very well the steps of a theorem. Steps of a theorem, 6 are there. One is statement, figure, given, RTP, construction and also proof. All the theorems need not to be a construction part. Construction most probably helping lines or any changes in a diagram we can express. Yes, here observe, statement already given. We draw a diagram students, some of you. Yes, this is the diagram. What they given? Triangle. Let me consider, ABC is a triangle. ABC is a triangle. Here three sides are there. One is AB, BC and also AC. Three sides. Observe the statement. A line drawn through the midpoint of one side. Midpoint of one side of a triangle. Yes, I think AB has one side. First of all, let me consider D is a midpoint of AB. D is a midpoint of AB. Yes, midpoint of AB. A line drawn through the midpoint of one side of a triangle parallel to another side. Through midpoint of AB, that is D, a draw a line. Okay, it is parallel to another side. It is parallel to another side. Now clear. What they give finally? Bisects the third side. This is the third side. Bisects the third side. Here, this line meeting at AC. At E. Okay students, this is the diagram students all of you. Right. Go for. So figure is completed. Go for next step. That is given. Yes. What we written here? In triangle ABC. In triangle ABC. Okay. D is a midpoint of AB. D is a midpoint of AB and this line is parallel to third side. That means DE is parallel to BC. Okay students, next one. And this line meeting AC at E. Yes, we can express here also. So and the line meeting AC at E. Okay, now clear the given part. Next go for RTP. So what we proved here? Bisects the third side. bisects the third side. Bisect means dividing into two equal parts. That is AE equal to EC. AE equal to EC. That is AE equal to means E is a which point? E is which point? Yes, E is a midpoint of AC. That is E is a midpoint of AC. Right. There is no changes here, so don't write construction part. Go for directly proof part. Yes, proof. Okay, after students. From the figure. Yes, by BPT. Already given here, D is parallel to BC. That means apply the BPT theorem. A line drawn parallel to one side of a triangle in two distinct points. Then the two distinct points are divided in the same ratio. That means according to the problem, AD by DB equal to AE by EC. So AD by DB equal to AE by EC. Let me consider, this is the first equation. Okay students, next one. And also given, what is given? D is a midpoint of AB. Here I express, D is a midpoint of AB. So midpoint means both values are equal. Yes, we know that. Therefore, AD equal to DB. AD equal to DB means their ratio must be equal to 1. So which implies this value taken in on left side, AD by DB equal to 1. AD by DB equal to 1, which is equation number 2. After both of them, here AD by DB is there, their value must be equal to 1. From 1 and 2, from first equation. So better to take round up students. Without round up, it is only numerical. With round up, it is a equation. Is represented equation. So from 1 comma 2, AE by EC equal to 1. AD by DB value must be equal to. AE by EC equal to 1. This AC transfer right side becomes, it becomes AC into 1, nothing but EC. Then that implies AE equal to EC into 1, EC. So AE equal to EC. That means E is a which point? Midpoint. Therefore, E is a midpoint of AC. So hence it is proved. So this is the way of process, students. So learn carefully and practice it. Yes. Observe students, this is also related to BPT theorem. What the given question, observe all of you. Draw a line segment of length 7.2 centimeters and divide it in the ratio of 5:3. Measure the two parts. It is also construction part, students. First of all, solution given. Observe carefully all of you. Right. Take a scale, students. Draw a line segment like this. AB. Take a scale and draw AB equal to 7.2 centimeters. Okay, next one. Draw an acute angle. That is angle BAX. Downside at A, draw one acute angle. Acute angle means less than 90 degrees. Okay, AX was taken. Okay, so we draw an acute angle. Next one. What is the ratio given here? 5:3. How many parts are there? So 5 + 3 = 8. Is it it or not? Yes. Take a compass at A. Observe students here. Take a compass like this. Draw. And also extend it. Right. Yes. So let me consider it is A1, A2, A3, also A4, A5, A6, A7, and also A8 students. Okay, right here, observe carefully. Marks of 8 parts on AX bar with equal ready. A1 equal to A1, A2 equal to A2, A3 and so on. Finally, A7, A8. Okay, next one. After that, join. By using scale, join A8 and B. Use the scale like this draw. Use scale and draw like this. So join A8 and B. Okay, we draw a parallel line. Subject in BPD theorem. Draw which is the first ratio 5 is there. Yes, 5 means A5 taken and also draw one line. A use scale and draw. Use scale students and draw. Okay. This line meet AB at the C. Meet AB at the C. Right. Is it clear all of you? Now take a scale and observe the mirrors of here. C divides AB in 5:3 ratio. Is it clear or not? Check it. Yes. AC length how much and BC length observe first of all. So here AC equal to and also BC equal to. Yes, by using scale, first measure AC and also BC. And write in rough out. Okay? Next. This is the way of construction. Yes, how can draw this? Observe students, all of you. Steps of construction. Steps of construction. Steps of construction. First one. What about the first point? Draw a line segment AB equal to 7.2 centimeters. That is the first one. And comes to second. Draw an acute angle. Angle BAX. BAX. At A. I repeat. Draw an acute angle with angle BAX at A. That is the second one. And go for third. Yes, mark of or marks of whatever it means. Marks of what is the ratio here? 5:3. So 5 + 3 equal to 8. So marks of 8 parts. Marks of 8 parts on AX bar with equal ready. With equal ready. That is A1 equal to A1, A2 equal to and so on. A7, A8. That is the third part. And go for fourth one. Okay students, after that what I did? And join A8 and B. Join A8 and B. Next, fifth one. Next, draw a parallel line at A5. At A5. Which means at AB. C, which means AB at C. Okay, students, draw a parallel line A8B at A5, which means AB at C. Next, go for sixth one. Next, here C divides. AB in the ratio 5:3. AB in the ratio 5:3. Next, seventh one. Last of the students. Yes. Measure the two parts. Here, AC equal to. Measure the two parts, AC. First one is 5. Is it or not? So that is 5 by total parts is 8. 5 by 8 into 7.2. So, catch with 8. So, 8, 0.9. 5 into 0.9. Nothing but 4.5 centimeters. Next, BC or CB. BC equal to. BC equal to 3 by 8 into 7.2. Cancel with 8. So it becomes 3 × 9 = 27. So that is 2.7 centimeters. Okay, students? Is it right or not? Check it once. Take a scale. Observe AC value. I thought it is equal to 4.5. And also measure BC value, that is equal to 2.7 centimeters. This construction is related to BPD theorem. Observe here. ABC is a triangle. And one line is parallel, one line drawn, it is parallel to third side. That is divided into same ratio. Observe A to A5 is equal to this side. That means A, A5 by A5, A8 equal to AC by BC. Okay? It is also related to BPD theorem. Yes, students, observe here one more important theorem. So that is converse of BPT. So converse of basic proportionality theorem. Observe the statement. So what is the statement? If a line divides two sides of a triangle. If a line divides two sides of a triangle. In the same ratio. Then the line is parallel to side third side. Then the line is parallel to third side. This is the statement, students. So learn carefully, all of you. So what I given here, this is the statement of the converse of BPT. If a line divides two sides of a triangle in the same ratio, then the line is parallel to third side. Yes, first of all, I draw a diagram like this. ABC is a triangle. Okay, a line divides, D is a line. Okay. If a line divide two sides of a triangle in the same ratio, then the line is parallel to third side. So diagram also completed. Observe given part of the students. In a triangle ABC, a line divides two sides of a triangle. Which is the line? D is a line. Triangle ABC. D is a line such that. So what they given? Divides in the same ratio. That means here AD by DB equal to AE by EC. Okay, student. This is the given part. Yes, RTP. What we proved here, observe carefully. Then the line is parallel to third side. That means DE is parallel to BC. Right. So there is no changes. Okay. Go for directly proof, students. Here, first of all, let us assume DE is not parallel to BC. So let us assume D is not parallel to BC. That is, so D does not parallel to BC. Okay? Next one. So which is parallel? We draw on the line like this. It is parallel to DE bar. So also, it is not parallel to BC. And again, it is parallel to it is parallel to BE dash. That is BE dash parallel to BC. BE dash parallel to BC. So a line is parallel to other side, then observe the BPT theorem, then ratio is same or one. So that is by using that one here. AD by DB equal to AD by DB equal to AE dash. AE dash by E dash C. Okay students, let me consider equation number one. And comes to second one. According to the given point, what they given? AD by DB equal to AE by EC. So according to the given, AD by DB equal to AE by EC, which is equation number 2. Since given, since here given date, given. Okay students, observe from equation 1 and 2, left side values are equal, automatically right side values also equal, right side values also equal. So then the reply is AE by EC equal to, so here from 1 comma 2 taken, from 1 comma 2, AE by EC equal to AE dash by E dash C. E dash C from 1 comma 2 students. Okay, here selecting the students all of you, right? Yes, that one. Adding one on both sides. So then I realize AE by EC plus 1 equal to AE dash, E dash by E dash C plus 1. Okay students, so observe carefully here it is. Yes, EC as a LCM of denominator, then what implies AE plus EC, come on, it becomes EC. Same as it is AE dash plus E dash C by E dash C. Okay, clear students? Then observe the numerator value AE plus EC. So AE plus EC nothing but AC. And again here next AE dash plus E dash C also nothing but AC. So here AC by EC equal to here also AC by E dash C. On both sides numerator values are cancelled. Then EC equal to E dash C. EC equal to E dash C means, is it right or wrong? So it is a wrong. This is wrong. So observe the diagram. Here DE line is separate, DE dash also separate. How it is equal? So when it is possible, okay, it is true for both lines are coincide to each other. Therefore, how it is true for E comma E dash are coincide. Therefore, Our assumption is wrong. Therefore, what we conclude finally? DE is parallel to BC. Okay, students, observe the given part. What they given? A line drawn parallel to a line divides the two sides in the same ratio, then the line is parallel to third side. We proved it here. Therefore, hence it is proved. This is the converse of BPT. Yes, observe students here. Here, textbook. In page number 197, try this problem. What they given? E and F are points on the sides PQ and QR respectively of line PQR. State whether EF parallel to QR or not. सब कर फर्स्ट वन PE 3.9 सेंटीमीटर PF इक्वल टू 3.6 सेंटीमीटर EZ इक्वल टू 3 सेंटीमीटर FR इक्वल टू 2.4 सेंटीमीटर फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई ड्रॉ ए डायग्राम सो ज्योमेट्री व्हाट बेटर टू ड्रॉ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल डायग्राम देन इजीली अंडरस्टूड एंड वी व्हाट वी फाइंड क्लियरली अंडरस्टूड इन दिस डायग्राम यस व्हाट इज गिवन First of all, I draw triangle PQR. Okay, students, and also EF is parallel to QR. So I draw EF here also as the same EF. Next, PE means 3.9 centimeters. Next, PF equal to 3.6 centimeters. Next, EZ 3 centimeters, and FR equal to 2.4 centimeters. So what they given here? What we wrote? EF parallel to QR. EF parallel to QR. So observe converse of BPT. What they given? A line drawn two sides of a triangle in the same ratio. Then the line is parallel to third side. Okay. Here, first of all, by BPT, PE by EQ equal to PF by FR theta. Ratio is same, then automatically the line is parallel to third side are not clearly same. Right? Observe here. First of all, by solution. Solution given by BPT. By BPT. Yes, observe here. What is BPT theorem? P by EQ equal to. And again, PF by FR. What about PE value here? So 3.9 by 3 equal to. Next one, 3.6 by 2.4. So here, cancel with. So 3 1 is 3, 3 3 is a 9. So 1.3 equal to. And comes to this side, 2.4. 2.4 once, and again 2.4, 1.5. So cancel with 1. This is 1.5 with the value students. So then 1.5. Here, the ratio is same or not, we check it. So 1.3 is equal to 1.5? So no, it's not. So 1.3 is not equal to 1.5. So here, the ratio is not equal. So by converse of BPT, what we conclude that, then that implies EF is not parallel to QR in this case, students. Okay, comes to the second problem. Also same, first draw a triangle as usual. So that is PQR. And also D is a line. So the PE 4 centimeters. PE 4 centimeters. QE. So again, next observe PF. PF. So EF, don't take here, not E, this is EF students. So EF, so PE, this side, PE equal to 4 centimeters and QE equal to 4.5 centimeters and PF equal to 8 centimeters. Next RF equal to 9 centimeters students. Yes, by using BPT theorem. So directly by BPT. So that is PE by EQ equal to PF by FR. PF by FR. So then 4 by 4.5 equal to next 8 by 9. Only right side will strike it off with 2. 2 4 is 8, 2 4.5 is 9. So then that implies 4 by 4.5 equal to 4 by 4.5. So here, ratio is same or not? The ratio is same. So then, by converse of BPT, then what we conclude that here, EF is parallel to QR. EF is parallel to QR. That is the way of approach by students. So, in first example, in first problem, EF is not parallel to QR. In second problem, EF is parallel to QR. Same like that, I give one more problem, practice all of you, your students. Observe here, D and E are points on the sides AB and AC of triangle ABC. AB equal to 12 centimeters, AD equal to 8 centimeters, AE equal to 12 centimeter, AC equal to 18 centimeter. Show that DE is parallel to BC. Okay?
Yes.
Observe students here. This is also related to converse of BPT theorem. Subject the problem and also analyze it carefully. Prove that a line joining the midpoints of any two sides of a triangle is parallel to the third side. Is parallel to the third side. Regarding this statement, yes, we draw diagram aside. I take ABC is a triangle. Okay. And again, observe what they given. A line joining the midpoints of any two sides. I take AB and AC midpoints are D and also E. D and also E. Yes, join the line segment like this. D. Okay. A line joining the midpoints of any two sides of a triangle is parallel to the third side. So we prove DE is parallel to BC. Yes, observe here by using theorem wise as usual. First given part in triangle ABC. In triangle ABC. Okay, D, E are midpoints. D, E are midpoints of. Midpoints of AB, AC respectively. AB, AC respectively. Right. Next one, RTP. What we prove here? D is parallel to BC. D is parallel to BC. Yes, go for proof, students, all of you. Yes, observe here. What are given first of all? Yes, D is a midpoint of AB. Okay, so D is a midpoint of AB. Midpoint of AB means then that implies AD equal to DB. AD equal to DB. That means which implies take the ratio AD by DB equal to 1. AD by DB equal to 1, which is equation number 1. And comes to second one, E is a midpoint of AC. Same procedure. AE equal to EC. So which implies AE by EC equal to 1, which is equation number 2. So from 1 and 2, right side values are equal. If right side values are equal, automatically left side values also equal. So from 1 comma 2, AE by DB equal to AE by EC. Observe converse of BPT. If ratio is same, then automatically the line is parallel to third side. And comes to this side, by converse of BPT. So what they given? Ratio is same, then automatically DE is parallel to BC. So hence it is proved. This is the way of approach, students. So, if you like this class, all of you subscribe the channel. Okay, students? Thank you.